Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain.
I can't hear you.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Oh! Okay, thank you. Hi, everyone, I'm Matt.
I'm Mike.
I'm Ken.
I'm Dave.
Welcome to Matt's Let's Play choice. I feel like we were foreshadowing this in every Let's Play.
I wanted to do it, so welcome to...
another SpongeBob Let's Play.
We're loading that cut off.
Battle for Bikini Bottom, Rehydrated. Some of you may know that we played this previously in like 2016, 2017, but now that the Rehydrated version came out, we're playing it again. And this time I'm playing it because Mike played the game originally.
Yeah, you play the hard version now.
This one's harder?
It's harder to get shiny objects.
Oh, it's not that hard though.
I'll lower it just a touch because it feels like it's screaming at me.
Oh, I don't know if you can turn those subtitles off, by the way.
I don't think it's that bad. Let everyone see the subtitles. So, this is the first Nickelodeon game that was published by THQ Nordic, because in like 2018 they made like some announcement that they were going to be bringing back a bunch of Nickelodeon games. And it was actually pretty funny, because when that announcement was made, there was one thing more loudly than ever that everyone was pretty much asking for. Battle for Bikini Bottom HD. Because, you know, a lot of people know that this is one of the most, like, popular licensed games out there, and it's one of the most beloved. But it's actually really popular not just for the game itself and for, like, the nostalgia of it, but it's really popular in the speedrunning community as well. A lot of people, like, really, really, really love this game. So for years, a lot of people were asking, like, oh my god, can we get, like, Battle for Bikini Bottom HD? Can we, like, I want to get a Battle for Bikini Bottom HD. And then when THQ and Nordic announced that they, like, were able to get the Nickelodeon license, everyone was like, it's happening! Battle for Bikini Bottom HD! It's happening! And now, here we are. So, I guess I'll go into my history with the game. I played the original game a lot as a kid, but I did not beat it until shortly after we did the Let's Play, which was, like, what, 2017, I think?
Something like that.
But I love the game a lot. It was one of my personal favorite licensed games and probably my favorite game based on a cartoon. And when the remake was announced, I was excited because I love the game a lot. And when I saw more gameplay, I did get a little bit skeptical at first because it just looked a little bit, you know, off. But now that I've played the game, I like it about as much as I like the original, which is a good thing, because I like the original a lot.
Do you guys have any history with this game?
Nope. Given their dead silence, I'm going to say
what?
The answer is probably...
I'm sorry.
Dave was literally just so unbelievably sucked in. I don't think he heard a word of what I just said.
Oh, about THQ Nordic remaking the games? Right? Aren't they the ones?
He heard about five words. Cool. All right, neat.
I literally...
Meanwhile, Kenny's on his phone playing another game. Being a great, great commentator.
I'm sorry.
With all the sarcasm in my bones as I say that.
Although I could add...
Next question for me.
Although I could add... This actually was my first actual SpongeBob game I played, and I owned it on the PS2. So I have fond memories of this game, and I did enjoy it a lot. So.
Yeah, this was our...
It was fun.
Did we have Super Sponge first?
Well... I want to say yeah, but I think we had Revenge of the Flying Dutchman, then Super Sponge.
Either way, this would have been our third, I think.
Yeah,
your Bikini Bottom stinks.
Yeah.
Your Bikini Bottom stinks? Is there another Bikini Bottom?
This is not a perfect recreation, though, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm mostly going to skip over the dialogue parts, but the cutscenes I'll show, of course.
Because it also kind of sucks, because in terms of Let's Playing, like... In terms of Let's Playing, in terms of being a remake, instead of doing something like Spyro or Crash where they re-recorded voice lines and everything, all the music, voices, and sound effects are ripped right out of the original game.
Yeah, they
makes sense.
They didn't really re-record anything.
I could tell because it still sounds the same.
Yeah,
even...
Matt skipped around the not Clancy Brown.
Here, look, hold on.
Faithful crew member of the Krusty Krab.
Oh God, they didn't
that
even.
That is not Mr. Krabs.
Yeah, they didn't. They did not give us back Clancy Brown.
Aww.
Sad truth is, I feel like he probably would have actually been down
to re-record
to record the line. Well, not even re-record because he never recorded them in the first place.
Yeah,
and since they ripped them straight from the original,
like I feel like he would probably be down, but it's just that I guess they never contacted him.
What's with the screen right now? Why can I only see half of the button?
I don't know. It's weirdly
probably because the thing's off kilter. Where
either that or Dave fucked with it yesterday when he
fixed it.
I think it actually is like that in the game. I do like that some of the pictures are references to like moments of the show, like what's shaking, my man.
I did mention some of the facts that they changed the pictures.
I was gonna say I did mention this before, but in the PC version of this game, there were modders who like went totally ham with this.
Mm-hmm.
And I mentioned before that they turned one of the characters into Buff Doge, and that some of those picture frames, instead of being SpongeBob characters, it was like a Raid Shadow Legends picture.
Raid Shadow Legends.
Every YouTuber's favorite advertising game. Raid Shadow
Legends. Yeah, I kind of wish YouTubers would just stop advertising the damn thing, but they got 1,000 pounds of money to throw around apparently, so, yeah.
I mean,
do what you gotta do.
Yeah, exactly.
Can't fault them for doing what they want.
What are you doing, man?
Aren't I supposed to jump onto...
No, the button's right there.
Oh, it's right here.
You have to do...
Well, there is a button that you need to get on the ball at it, but, you know.
Okay, there's no hidden spatula in here, right? There's only the one
sock. Oh, no, there's just a sock.
Just a sock.
Yeah, you need to get the ball over there.
Over to that thing. Push.
Push, push, push.
And I was literally going to ask that earlier, was, like, did they get all of the, like, original voice actors to do the voices, but...
In the original game, no.
In the original game, the only two that... the only two that never...
Matt, just jump on the trampoline.
Oh. Duh. Don't start.
It's so hard not to.
Don't start.
Mike's a backseat gamer. Like, what are you...
Well, then I'll, you know, put him in the trunk.
What were you guys saying for the voice
actors? For the original voice actors, only two of them were not brought back. Mr. Krabs and Mermaid Man.
Which is sad, because even these days, if they wanted to bring back Mermaid Man, they couldn't.
Obviously.
Yeah. Obviously.
Obviously.
R.I.P.
And Barnacle Boy both died, Reese.
Yep.
Not recently, but within the last 5 years, I think.
Yes.
Mm. No, Ernest Borgnine was 2012.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, he was earlier than I thought. Which is why they retired the characters, obviously. I do like how these are a little bit more animated than they were originally.
Yeah, because in the past, they each only had, like, one... One standing animation.
One thing I will say right now that I do hate most about this remake is that... You see when it says combo when you break those boxes? Yeah. When you get into a high enough combo, it will actually give you some more shiny objects.
Oh, by the way, the blue ones can only be destroyed by, like, the blue ones on the ground is by the bowling one, right? Or is it
Or you could just tiptoe over, but seeing as Matt won't ever slow down, I don't
think
that'll happen.
Mike, why do you have to be such a
no,
jerk?
No, it's not me being a jerk. I'm saying, realistically, there's no point in slowing down. Just use the bowling ball on them. Why do you think everything I say is being a jerk? I'm not Squidward.
I say it all the time, your tone of voice, whether you know it or not. Anyway, see, I tiptoed. Press the L2 button.
Matt, you have to stop.
Like
Matt,
this.
Matt, you're an ass.
You got room to talk.
I know.
Oh, by the
way. Wait, isn't he supposed to have a sock with him?
Hey, Patrick. Nice cock. That was one of the edits that a lot of people made with that line.
I forget. How many socks do you have to give Patrick for a
10
scratch?
Each. There's 100 overall in the game.
80.
Oh, 80?
There's only 80, yeah.
My bad. I thought it was...
I love how it does that and you still lose seconds.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was like that in the original.
I know it was, but I'm just saying it's like, in a general sense, I'm like, oh.
Damn it. That just... probably not gonna...
Now you're definitely gonna
try
your hardest to get it.
I'm not going to.
Not with that quitter talk, mister.
Well, I could at least get
in 5 seconds.
Hey, you could try at least. Again, okay, another thing I really do hate about this remake is that when it, you get the extra underwear or you start a new area, they don't give you your health back.
Huh.
Oh, right, really? I just realized that. I got a golden pair of underwear, but I didn't get an extra pair of underwear from it.
Yeah.
You have to go back in SpongeBob's house if you want to get the extra underwear.
Or you could just find underwear just laying around.
There we go.
The golden spatula.
The plot MacGuffins of this game.
They're basically... because this game is pretty much just like... It was basically just Banjo-Kazooie with SpongeBob.
Or Mario 64.
Or Mario 64. You could call the golden spatulas this game's version of either Power Stars or Jiggies, whichever one you want to call it.
I do hate, by the way, another thing I hate is that how everything has to load the minute that you get into something. Like, you just saw the textures, like, load on everything, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, look, it's Handsome Squidward.
Yeah.
Mm.
There's a golden spatula here if you jump around like an asshole.
Like I just did.
Yay! You get a golden spatula for destroying Squidward's house.
Don't forget to give Squidward a mustache.
Because I gotta see if he... Aw. In the original game, when you give him the mustache, he goes, "Hang!" And it's funny, because it's a good sound effect.
Yeah. I forgot, in the original one, too, like, whenever you got a spatula, it did an autosave, right? Like, you froze for a second, it said auto-saving?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm very glad it autosaves, yeah. Oh, wait, I never got my words out, because Matt thought I was being an ass. Yeah, it's yours.
No.
Because you assumed. But my point is...
Anyway...
You see how they're supposed to give you, like, a combo, and after the combo they give you a few extra shinies?
Oh, yes.
In this version, they removed the highest one, and after... I think it stops at, like, super monster combo, when originally it was super ultra mega monster combo.
Yeah.
And that would have given you, like, 1,000 shiny objects as total. But now, it just stops at super monster combo, and you only get, like, the most is 100. Which makes getting the Mr. Krabs spatulas very hard. Especially in this version, originally.
How many does he give you?
Mr. Krabs gives you 8. It starts at 3,000 and goes up 500 with each one.
Because I want to see how much I need right now.
3,000.
Oh, you won't tell me. But like you said, 3,000. Okay, so...
Oh, are you going into Patrick class or not?
Alright, I forgot I have to go there. I saw the shinies.
But when this game came out originally... Oh, God.
Okay.
Lord
almighty.
In the original game... You needed a grand total of 30,000 shiny objects to get all the spatulas from Mr. Krabs, alright? Which you get accumulating over game time, alright? It's not something you had to do immediately, okay?
Mm-hmm.
When this game was released originally, you needed about 75,000 spatulas, shiny objects to get the spatulas. Because instead of doing it like, it starts at 3,000, getting those to 3,500... 4,000, 4,500. The original version of this game was 3,000, 6,000, 9,000, 12,000, 15,000, 18,000, 21,000. And I think it ended up with the last one was 24,000. And people bitched about it so hard they had to put back the original amounts of the shiny objects for the spatulas. Because it was just so hard to grind that many shiny objects in this particular version of the game because they took out that combo I mentioned.
Well, I mean, it would be that hard when you have that many.
Yeah. I was also going to mention off topic from that. I just got a message from Sopan.
Okay, here we go.
And we're mentioning this in the YouTube
video. No. Do you know what she said? I just want to say it's funny because she's like, I was playing Scarlet Nexus, but I forgot at your house. How am I playing it now?
What?
She wanted to play the game, but she left it at his house.
Oh, wow. I was like, the fuck is he talking about?
I was like, oh. Right.
I mean, I will admit the game looks great.
Yeah, I was a little worried about the graphics at first, but they look better when you play the game. Except when you play them on Switch. The people can't see it, but Mike nodded.
Mm-hmm.
Little fun story.
I hope you get molasses.
Do you know what molasses is?
Isn't it honey?
I think.
Well, he bandaged up his nose pretty quick.
Because I was going to say, what am I going to do with molasses?
I don't know, get it stuck on your feet and not be able to move anywhere.
Thank you, SpongeBob.
Yeah.
No,
Did he ever get that voice?
Tom Kenny can do it.
I was mentioning the thing with the Switch version is... I've told you guys this story, but this is more for the people. Mike originally ordered this version of the game off the internet. It is actually, surprisingly, the PAL version of the game.
It came for like $10 cheaper than America.
So, yeah, first time we're ever playing a PAL version of a game for a Let's Play, I think, maybe.
It doesn't really matter much. There's no difference between the versions.
I know.
Wait, this is the PAL version?
Yeah. Here, check the box. It has Peggy on it, dude.
But either way...
No, because the main thing was I didn't think the PAL version of a Blu-ray would be able to play because they're region 2.
No, they're region 3.
Huh.
Trust me, I did the fucking research. I actually got pissed off when I saw it was the PAL version. I was like, wait, I thought I'm just getting a version of the game.
So what's the difference between PAL version and non...
NTSC is America, PAL is Europe.
Well, the other thing is, because the other thing is the region. As you know, region locking was a thing
for a long time.
And
yeah.
The idea was, well, not the idea, but the thing was that the regions for Blu-rays were different than like DVDs. So like region A is America and Japan. So like if you bought a Japanese version of the game, you could play it on the... American PlayStation 4, 5, but the European was region B, so you can only play it on European one.
But this one is region 3, thankfully.
Yeah.
But the story I was getting into with the Switch one is, Mike ordered it, but it was one of those things where on launch day it didn't come, and reasonably, because Mike wanted to play the game, he got impatient, so he decided, I'm just going to buy the game on the Switch. Bad idea.
Yeah, because for some reason the PlayStation version wasn't popping up.
Oh, that explains it.
It was a bad idea because to this day, the Switch version is still the worst way to play this game.
What a surprise. I've never heard that before in a third-party game.
I wanted some hope because it was just a port. This is essentially a port, alright?
No, I know. I just wanted to make the joke.
This is essentially a port, and the Switch can't run a port correctly.
I'll be honest.
Saying the Switch is a bad system,
I was going to say, we don't need to qualify it with that.
Just saying, if Mario Odyssey exists, how does a port fuck up this bad?
I would like to point this out, and this is going to be a hot take maybe, but I'm going to say it. I played a little bit of the Switch version when Mike was playing it, just to see if it felt bad. Kind of did.
Well, what's the hot take here?
I played Doom on the Switch. Doom 2016.
Okay.
That shit played better on the Switch than Battle for Bikini Bottom Rehydrated did on the Switch, and Doom 2016 is a far more demanding game. That game probably played in handheld mode at, like, standard definition. And I think Doom 2016 played better on the Switch than fucking SpongeBob did from what I played.
I only played a little bit of Doom on the Switch, so I can't really attest to it.
But that's why I just give that as a hot take, because Doom is, we all know it, it's a more demanding game.
I was surprised Doom didn't make the Switch melt.
Might as well have.
Oh, it wasn't Crysis, so it wasn't going to do that.
Because I'll mention this, I played Doom 2016 on the Switch. Most of my playthrough was in handheld mode. So that was a more gratifying experience
on
the Switch.
You did miss one, but... I don't think it matters.
What, a shiny object?
Yeah.
Oh, poop. I don't know why it came out like that. I was just trying to make a noise, but it came out as me saying, oh, poop.
You lost some underwear.
Matt, thank you,
Dave, for pointing out the obvious.
Dave, we don't need narration here.
Dave is basically just the person who points out the obvious. You collected a shiny object. You brushed your teeth in the morning. You took a leak.
Again, you're not Far Cry 6's narrator. Please don't do this to me.
But
Far Cry 6 has a narrator.
It has narrator for the minute you start up to the minute you turn it off.
Cause they
Please press cross button.
Because they have that thing where it's like voice to text for, I don't know.
For, I guess.
It's like an accessibility thing, but I'm not specifically sure what for. Let's see, can I do this? Good. No? Oh, that worked.
Yeah,
it looked like you got hit. It looked like I didn't collect the underwear.
Yeah, you got hit and then immediately phased through the spot where the underwear was.
That's why I was confused.
You didn't hear him. Jump back up from right there and not have to go all the way back around.
Let's see. From here?
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, I thought it was going to hit me. But yeah, I was saying that with Doom and stuff, I played most of Doom 2016 on Switch in handheld mode, and it played better than what I played of this game docked on the Switch.
Is Doom Eternal on Switch or not?
It is, but it's digital only. That was the thing. Like, they ended up releasing Doom Eternal on the Switch, like, months and months later. Like, originally it was going to be a day-and-date release, but when the game got delayed, they ended up delaying the Switch version.
Is it any better or worse than the original?
I don't know enough to attest. It's X, that's what it was.
I thought you had it originally, honestly.
I thought I did too, but I guess not. But yeah, I haven't played Doom Eternal on Switch, so I can't attest to it. I think I've heard people say that it does do well for what it is. You know, a Switch port of a game like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't attest to it, because I haven't played it on the Switch.
Which game?
Doom Eternal.
Hmm. Ken, where are you right now? You're listening. I thought you're looking.
Both of these two are in the.
Oh no! I thought I was the Eternal part.
I was gonna say I thought I was the one that's dead on my feet because I am pretty tired.
Boom!
But these guys are just literally like dead.
You didn't want to watch the robot cutscene.
All I was gonna do is let you know that there is a robot who has a hammer.
But don't kish.
Yeah, it's a hammer that is also ham.
Waka waka.
Waka waka.
It's so much harder to get the shiny object when it stops right there in terms of comboing.
Yeah.
They should have like a... No, I was going to say... I don't know if this is actually a good idea.
Oh, shit. Wait, go back to that robot.
What robot?
The one on the ground. The one you... There it is. Right there. Jump up there. That robot is from the PC version.
Oh. For a minute, I was like, is that Invader Zim?
Mm-hmm. Oh.
I'm gonna sing the Doom song now.
I was saying, they should have a cheat code that, like, doubles the multiplier of the shiny objects.
Well, the cheat codes that were in the original game don't work in this version, so yeah.
I didn't know the original game had cheat codes.
Yeah, how do you think I speedrun the game now?
It was a PS2 game. Of course it had cheat codes.
Yeah, because people liked those at the time.
Yeah.
That was a thing that people used for fun.
Yeah. We're saying, game developers, get it together. We like cheat codes.
Well, that's what most accessibility options are these days.
You gotta climb.
Climb...
No, you gotta
continue. Oh, I gotta climb over level. There. Right, okay. Continue level. My bad.
Also, this is a backtrack level.
Yeah.
You can't get everything in this level until we come back with, like, the power-ups from the other, from the boss fights.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Because it wouldn't be a 3D platformer in the 2000s if there wasn't backtracking.
Yeah, but this is I'm the only level that does
Banjo-Tooie.
Yeah, but this is the only level that does that.
Tons and tons of backtracking.
Very good. Thank you.
Okay, this and the needle.
Okay. Was it me or did it look like that there was no boxes underneath and they still were?
Yeah, yeah. Again, not a perfect one-to-one transition to the original game. In fact, I think the physics here are a little bit worse.
I would like to hear why you think that.
Well, honestly,
I was going to disagree, but I want to hear your opinion.
Well, honestly, the jumping and everything feels fine. It's just that when the robots hit you or when the boxes, like, it doesn't look as fluid as it did originally.
Nope. No, I was going to say I wanted to, but I'm like, man.
I mean, you could have. I don't know what happened there.
Oh.
Did you second guess yourself?
Maybe.
You might have missed.
Like, if you hit those boxes...
Well, I fell, so of course I missed. Get off your phone.
I thought it was either you missed or you phased through the box.
That doesn't take away from my other point. Get off your phone. You're becoming Dave now.
He messed.
I'm still paying attention here.
As best
okay,
as you can.
But still, get off the phone.
Oh my god.
You know I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna tell you this. When you're playing a full-blown card game on your phone, I'm going to mention
it. Stop it! Stop! Can't you see your constant fighting is tearing us all apart?
What?
You have room to talk.
Well, I was just Nickelodeon referencing you again, but okay, fuck me, right?
I know. You were talking about that wild and crazy hot-blooded feeling. Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krat? Because it's from that episode.
No, I was quoting Carl, but alright.
Oh, I thought Pearl says that. No, she says something different.
What does Pearl say?
It was in the episode with the, I'm ready to party, are you ready to party?
Oh, yeah.
And then she says, like, stop it.
You're embarrassing me.
That's what it was.
Oh, you're not going to take the trampoline to the other shock?
I'm dumb. Where's the other
You trampoline that. Instead of going forward, instead of going that way, you turn the camera 90 degrees and go over there where that tree is. Can you tell I've played this game too much?
I suppose. I didn't know that I wasn't going to get to this anyway. Thank you.
This is one of the reasons it took me so long to 100% this game when it came out originally. Looking for these socks is such bullshit. Especially since back in the day, they didn't have guides for where the socks were.
Well, thank you for being my second pair of eyes.
You're welcome.
Does anyone think it's weird that there's water underwater?
I was going to say, this show has made this joke before.
Yes.
Well, actually, here's the thing.
By the way,
I found out
the teleportation box.
This actually isn't water.
It's goo.
It's goo. Realistically, under the sea, there are hot pools of smoldering goo.
Okay.
That some fish like.
So, we just got to this part. I guess tune in for the next part.
What time are we at?
27.
Oh, sure. Okay.
Yeah, let's tune in.
The next part, we'll continue through jellyfish fields as we make our way to King Jellyfish.
Thank you from our next time on Freedom Fighters narrator, Dave.
I could just do it next time on Freedom Fighter Z.
No, thank you. See you guys in the next part.
See ya.